to the NFL on EA Sports. In today's game, we should look to the war up front. The Packers are top 10 in rushing yards, going up against the Seahawks front seven that will need to be up to the test.
We are at the oldest continually operating stadium in the NFL as you get a look inside Lambeau Field in Green Bay, Wisconsin. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it. This crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Seattle Seahawks and the Green Bay Packers. Now contact up front as penalty markers come in. Who is this against? A little eager there coming in from his outside linebacker position.
You think the hard count got him there?
Yes.
Maybe that extra hut, you know, that extra emphasis on it, got him to jump, and they picked up 5 yards.
Here on first down. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. That's caught inside the 20. A big play that time for the Seahawks. 52 yards. And I guess, Charles, sometimes when you have a receiver well over 6 foot, you do that. Just put it up there, let him grab it, and he did.
And it certainly appears like a 50-50 ball, right? We always talk about that one. Both sides have a chance to get it, the receiver or the guy covering him. But I think the odds actually are in favor of the offense.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack.
It's interesting, partner, that most defenses try and guard the 35-yard line actively because they think the way kickers are nowadays, about a 52-yard field goal, they're kind of giving up points. But you get even deeper into territory, you get into the red zone, they're going to guard it even more, which means more pressure, more blitzing.
Wilson on second down. Oh, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more. Von Miller in there to drop him, and sacks on first and second downs are going to lead to a third and long. Wilson of the Seahawks looking for something big following the sack. It's third and long here. And some changes here as the D-line separates some. Third and long, it's Wilson. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
This defense is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
And his kick is absolutely perfect. And the Seahawks grab a 3-0 lead. Well, it's a night game, a lot of energy in this building. But the visiting team here, they get the ball in the opening drive, and they find a way to at least produce three.
And things are just getting started, so you can't say that they've taken the momentum totally, but a good start towards seizing it in this game.
And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. Knocked down hard, right around the 31. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down. 6 yards here to go for the offense on second down.
Now let's go! Green, 39!
Here's Garoppolo to throw. They go screen pass to Hyde. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. Give him six on the screen, but now it's third down.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. They'll run it. Here's Hyde.
Man, what were they thinking on defense there? That looked like they were playing for the pass. That was third and short. Yeah, it was an easy pickup because they handed it to him. That was way too easy.
Just looked like absolute confusion defensively. Not sure why they were in that set.
Yeah, I'd say you ought to have a few men in the box there.
Contact. He is knocked down hard right there around the 35-yard line.
Every year I go to the combine, I marvel at the speeds that linebackers are running nowadays. They run like DBs. And let's face it, they know how to finish plays, too. Eyes up, head up, run right through them.
Now this time, Garoppolo will throw. And the Seahawk defense gets to him, and they bring him down. I know some of the talk after last week's loss was the O-line struggles. They gave up four sacks. He got hit here and taken down again, so that's something to monitor.
It is something to monitor, but they've got to help their offensive line out. Maybe a little bit different play calling, right? Draws, screens, get the ball out of the quarterback's hands quicker, maybe some quick game passes. All of that to try and help slow down a pass rush and make things easier on their offensive line.
He finds Randall Cobb with a completion. And he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line. They do get 18, but even that won't be quite enough. It's fourth down. Well, the Seahawks come after it, and they block it. Now it's scooped up, and this is a live football. Pass the 20, 10, and it's a Seattle Seahawks touchdown.
Partners, you well know every block punt wasn't necessarily a called block. Sometimes the guy just finds his way back there. Doesn't matter. The play happens, and that one turned into 6 points because they handled it so well after the block.
Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. Now the return. Here comes Randall Cobb. And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. They go play action here on first down. He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. They'll get a couple yards on that one, and it'll be a second down.
And the big guy catches the ball out of the backfield, and oftentimes it's quite a surprise to the guys playing defense because not ordinarily thought as a pass catcher, it often works when they decide to dial it up.
Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. They fake the give. Now Garoppolo looks to throw. And his throw is incomplete. They were trying to get it there to Sterling Shepard. And it's third down.
Well, they're slinging it. And then there's one you got to put a timer on, huh? I mean, that one came in hot.
That came in hot, but overthrown, out of his reach and incomplete. And on third and eight, defensively, they're going to beef up the secondary. Six defensive backs. A shotgun snap for Garoppolo. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
It's a great job by this secondary. When I watch them, they remind me of elite defenders on a basketball court, right? They want to contest each and every pass.
Great contest on third down to bring up fourth.
And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. This is fielded inside the five. And hello, he's going to be knocked backward as he'll be marked down. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And they split the uprights last time for three. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Run what
put
you
your
do
foot
best.
On the gas.
Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead in a big way. The best way to do it? Touchdowns.
And he's able to get this one all the way past the 30. That burst good for 20 and a first down.
And that's why defense coordinators always preach 11 guys to the ball. Because sometimes you have a missed tackle, but if you have a swarm of guys around, less room for them to roam even after the first missed tackle. In this case, tackle was missed, plenty of open field to get after that.
They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains.
Nice little nifty play for him there. Yeah, that's the ability to read a defense and utilize players that don't often get picked up in coverage easily. And I'm talking about being able to use the backs out of the backfield. Because I know that when I used to cover, hey, we got everybody covered. Oh, he just snuck out there, and they just got a nice first down there.
What do we love to say? Get those backs into space, right? And they were able to do that there. Nice pickup on first down. Throwing now, Wilson on first down. He's going to fire one deep, middle of the field. And it drops down incomplete. Thought he might have had it. Instead, second down.
One thing I know from experience is that when the deep ball is thrown and you're the defender, you've got to fight that little bit of panic that emerges. You've got to play the ball really well. It's a 50-50 jump ball play. And guess what? They took a shot. Are you going to win it? And in this case, they managed to get it done.
Second down following the incompletion. And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. And he takes it across midfield to the 45. Pretty good running there, 9 yards. Sets up a third and one.
Nice job there defensively on third down. Not only did they string the play out, but they didn't allow any room for a cutback. Really well organized on the defensive side.
Alongside my broadcast partner, Charles Davis, Brandon Gauden hits the Seahawks. It looks like the Packers have added an extra DB on third down. Call it no gain on the keeper, and it's going to bring up a fourth down. So on now is the Clemson man, Bradley Pinion, to punt this one away. This is away, and it's a high kick, hit pretty well. And this is going to carry well into the end zone for a touchback. The Packers offense now, they get ready to head back onto the field. And three and out on the last drive. No points on the scoreboard. A little soul-searching now?
I would say so. They need to help out their defense a little bit. They've got to be on the field a lot more than normal, put them in some tough spots, but... what's the old adage? When you get another chance, it gives you a better chance to do it right.
A really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks.
Here we go now.
There's Garoppolo on first and 10. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
He kind of forced that one there, didn't he? It's almost like he predetermined where he was going to go with the football.
Yeah, he wasn't really going through progressions. He wanted to go to his top guy. You do that against this defense, they'll make you pay, won't they?
Yeah, they certainly will. They react very quickly to the thrown football.
Garoppolo again here on second and 10. It's hauled in by Shepherd. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs. Thank you.
Looking left side. It's complete. He's got it. Touchdown, Packers. Trey Burton, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Packers are back within a score. When they drew that up, I don't think they envisioned it ending in a house call. But he got it and took it all the way home.
Really impressive run after the catch, wasn't it? That was really special by him. But let's face it, in today's NFL, those tight ends are often former wide receivers or maybe even sometimes bigger running backs. They just put them in a position to get a great matchup and make plays like that.
This will be fielded at the 8. And good starting field position. He'll get this one all the way up to about the 35-yard line. And out now come the Seahawks. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a cushion, put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone.
Off the play fake. Here's Wilson. And he finds a man with a crossing route. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40. A very solid gain of 27. Now flags will come in. I think this one's going to be on the defense for jumping. So 5 yards there as one of the big guys up front moved.
And in a 4-3 front, you got the two defensive tackles right near the football. I know there's a lot of movement around there, but they're always taught to have one eye on the football. Apparently, that didn't happen.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And not much running room. Down to the 32. Four yards remaining now on second down. Shipped together here from the D-line. And now whistles and a flag, and I think we got a jump here. Jumpy on the right side of the line.
Sometimes when you're on the end, a little bit farther away from the ball, any type of movement will get you to jump, and that's exactly what happened there.
Down, they'll run it on the draw play. And not much of a hole there as he gets it down to about the 24-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Not much happening there on first down.
I thought there might have been a hole for a split second.
Yeah, but it dried up pretty quickly, didn't it? Closed fast.
Second down, here's Wilson, letting one go deep for the end zone, and he can't hang on. That's definitely going to be one he wishes he had back. Incomplete in the end zone.
Coverage was very good that time. A nice job to smother him as the ball arrived, and that ensured an incomplete pass.
And it keeps 6 points off the board. Now contact up front as penalty markers come in. Who is this against? And he got a little aggressive too early.
And he did, wanting that quick takeoff as the ball was snapped. But I think sometimes those big guys on offense, they're pretty cagey too, right? They make those little sudden moves or those little subtle moves that get you to jump.
They'll bring a receiver in motion right. Third and two. Now Wilson. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. And he'll get it down this time to the 17. Give him 2 yards on that play. And that's going to bring up a fourth down.
Well, it wasn't a big strike, but that completion put them in really great range. What do we have now, fourth and inches?
Yeah, it's not more than a half a foot.
You know what I would do here?
You would always go for it.
I'm one of those guys.
And for the second time tonight, this field goal unit comes out here. From the right hash, just a... And the holder's going to keep it. He's going to try to run for it. And they're able to pick up the first and keep possession. He'll grab 3 yards on the play, taking it himself for the first down.
I'm well aware this is not basketball, but this feels like full court pressure. Never getting out of that the entire time. Just stay on top of them. With that lead, go ahead and fake it and continue to try and build on it.
Yeah, first half, as you said, you got that lead, but they want a bigger cushion here. They're hitting the gas pedal hard. On first down, Wilson. And it's caught. And he is in for the Seattle touchdown.
The defense is doing their best, but they're struggling right now. They'll look for some help from their own offense to keep them in the game.
Bailey now for the extra point. It's good to make it 17-7. Bailey now to kick this one away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Packers offense now heading back out onto the field. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minutes. Who knows? Let's see what they decide to do.
Throwing on first is Garoppolo. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Shepard. That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be second down.
Well, I know it goes against the instincts of the person catching the ball, because all you're ever taught is catch the football, don't drop it.
But drop it there.
Yeah, in that situation, dropping it would have been better. End up losing yardage, even though they completed the pass.
As good as a sack.
Yeah, how about that? Although they won't get the same credit for it, and it won't help them at contract time.
Caught left side by Kyle. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Give him 30 yards there.
The one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown them a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after them. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. The defensive line disperses a little bit here, maybe expecting a pass. On second down, Hyde. Trying to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. No gain on the play as we have reached the 2-minute warning. 2 minutes to go here in the first half. We're back to Lambeau following these words. The Packers on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 10. Now flags will come in. I think this one's going to be on the defense for jumping. So a jump there defensively.
It's a killer. Watch the football. Don't move across the line of scrimmage until the ball moves.
The Packers on third down. Just 1 for 3 thus far. This will be 3rd and 5. Working from the gun, Garoppolo. He's got his target, it's Cobb. Give him 12 yards on that one, it earns him a fresh set of downs.
A little football 101 there. You just see the receiver try to run down the defender, meaning he goes right at him, and really trying to move him a little bit towards the center of the field so he can put his foot in the ground and break to the out, to the sideline, and make a catch.
Mm-hmm. set up the screen to Montgomery. And he'll go down here right around the 23-yard line. A good pickup there on first as the screen pass gets him eight.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
And back to the ground. High. And he'll be taken down near the 20 at the 21. Only a yard on the pickup, so a good situation on second and two. It's now third and one. And now the Seahawks are going to take a timeout here on defense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. This will be play number seven on the drive. Third and a yard. And some extras coming up on the line here. Redding for the blitz. Garoppolo now. It's caught. Shepherd. And he'll have the first down, getting this one to the 14-yard line. It's a seven-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains. First down, a run with Hyde. He's going to work this one down to about the five. Now this will be the ninth play on this drive. To the ground, this time Montgomery, and he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. It's a 3-yard pickup, and that sets up a first and goal.
At this stage of the game, the run pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of the yardage has come through the air, but in a sense that just sets things up for big runs like that because the defense might be a little bit off balance. They pick up another first down with that run.
From the gun, it's Garoppolo. And that is caught, but he will come down out of bounds, says the side judge, incomplete. Randall Cobb, the intended receiver. That'll bring up second down. So a challenge coming down from the booth, and that's where these challenges come from, of course, in the final 2 minutes of the half.
Yeah, now we're going to New York, right? That's command central for the officials. They'll talk, they'll take a look at it, communicate with the referee at the game site, and issue a final decision because they do have the final call now.
Well, just play after play after play on this long drive for the offense. Second down, here's Garoppolo. In trouble, and he'll go down back at the 12. And now maybe they want some extra time to talk about this third and long play as we'll get a timeout. As they'll stop it with 13 seconds to play in half number one. So the sack of Garoppolo. And now what can they come up with on third and long? To throw is Garoppolo. And the snap will come inside the five at the four. And offensively, they'll take the timeout with 6 seconds left in the second quarter.
Well, partner, nothing comes open here, so he decides to escape out of there, and he doesn't pick up a first down, but he does gain additional yardage to set up a possible field goal attempt if they decide to go that route.
So a field goal here, they're still down, but they put a dent into that lead before the break.
And that's got to feel good, because now they've seen that they can put some more points on the board, and that gives them a whole second half to get back to where they want to be, and that's in the lead.
This will be fielded at the 8. So we've come upon halftime. And actually, Larry, hold that thought. We're right back to the action. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. This will be fielded at the 8. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. Now trotting out there, the Packers getting ready to go. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team.
Pressure comes. He's taken down by the Seahawk defense.
Well, they go play fake. The problem is nobody was faked out.
And when no one's faked out, what's the end result? Sad. Quarterback gets hit.
So the D-line's going to spread out. Now Garoppolo throwing on second. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Burton. And he's brought down after a good game. He got 29 yards that time.
There are so many things to watch for when you play defense. And reading your keys, you always hear about that. And having your eyes in the right place. Sometimes your eyes can fool you. How about that play action there? That sprang the big guy, didn't it?
Able to dump it over the top to him. First down, here's the run with Montgomery. Slipped one tackle, but no more as he's knocked to the deck behind the line of scrimmage. So a loss of five, and it'll be second down.
So statistically, both of these offenses having a rough time getting a running game going. But boy, what a nice play there defensively.
Tackling him behind the line, but you're right, you look at the numbers. Neither side looks on track in the ground game. Garoppolo to throw on second down. Throw left side complete. It's Burton. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. The Packers on third down. They've hit it 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This is third and 11. On play action, now Garoppolo. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the all-pro free safety, Earl Thomas. And this one will be returned to right around the 38-yard line. First possession of the third quarter, an interception, so maybe a second-half tone setter.
Indeed, and not the tone they wanted to set. That's the equivalent of running out the wrong door and running into your pool instead of running out onto the field. A real dud for that one.
Has that happened to you before?
No, but I've heard stories about teams actually doing that back in the good old days.
And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on it at second down.
The positioning here is key. As a defensive back, you're taught 99% of the time make a play on the football. But in this case, making a play on the man was all the difference. That's what forced the incompletion.
And the wide out in motion.
19.
Now they'll run it on the toss. And a good swarm to the football defensively as they get him down at about the 40. Call it about a gain of 3, and they'll be looking at a 3rd and 7 coming up.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down, then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in an expected passing situation.
Now a handoff looking right. Oh, he's got some breathing room. That good for 22 and a first down.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. So the run moves the chains, and here we go on first down. And he motions the wide receiver. Now a play fake here on first down. He's going to loft one deep left side here. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
Tremendous field position there and a perfect time to do exactly what they did. Take a shot at the end zone. And they went for the big play, just unable to complete it.
So the incomplete pass brings up second down. Wilson, going to throw again. And he is out of bounds
just a yard or two shy of the 10. A very solid gain of 27.
I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together. When the top part, catching the football, right, whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs, in this case, the feet, doing a little toe tap to stay in bounds and complete the catch.
And a great job by our crew on the camera shot. Love when you see the grass or on the field turf, those rubber pellets flying up. Great catch.
And it is true. You can draft the fastest. You can draft the most athletic guys. But if they don't know the art of positioning, sometimes it's all for naught. In this case, in the right spot, helped force the incompletion.
Yeah, but had his hands on it for a second. Would have been a tough catch, though. Falls incomplete. Now they'll pitch it out here. They get six here after the incompletion, and it'll leave them with a third and four.
Looks to me like maybe there's a little attrition setting in with this drive, because when you see that type of a run, I get the feeling the defense getting a little bit tired.
And that's the last thing they need, especially when they look up at the scoreboard. The Seahawks on third down. They've only converted once in four tries. This is third and four. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. On third down, it's Flowers. And he will push his way forward down to about the three-yard line. 2 yards on the pick up there. It's fourth down.
But forget knowing where the first down line was. This defense created their own line of scrimmage. They won every battle up front. And a lot of times that is one-on-one. If you win your one-on-ones enough times, your defense is going to be pretty good. They had more people to the football and snuffed out the play.
So put another three on the board. And all things considered, a good opening drive here to begin the third quarter.
It sure was. I think as a head coach, you're happy to come out and put a little drive together, take the 3 points, and build on your lead.
And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. The Packers offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. 12 yards there as they move the chains.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, ball may come your way.
And the offense lining up first and 10. Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. Running left, Montgomery. And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. He lost six there on the first down play.
But these guys are going to chop into that deficit. They're going to have to do a much better job in the run game. Caught behind the line of scrimmage, no yardage will be found.
Back to the ground. This time it's high. And he'll get this one up to about the 39 here. Now we have Hyde still on the ground here, staying down after that last play. We'll check on his status when we get back. The Packers on third down, 3 for 7 so far in this game. This is third and 11. Here's Garoppolo to throw. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
We're into the second half now, and this is an offense that continues to struggle to sustain a drive.
Looks like they're just totally out of sync, whether they're running the ball, passing the ball like we saw there. I don't know. The rhythm seems off. Oh, the Seahawks come after it, and they block it. Now it's scooped up, and this is a live football. So much for pinning him really deep. Short punt could have pinned him inside the 10. Now great field position the other way.
It's never good when you're punting the ball and your eyes see the ball go back behind you.
No.
In however form, whether it's over your head or to the side, never good. Now it becomes a race to get to the football so they don't pick it up and take it all the way.
action. Now Wilson. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by the Michigan man, Jake Ryan. The 40, 20, 10. And into the end zone. It's a pick six and a Packer touchdown. Short throw pick six right there. Those linebackers, they love when those short throws come and those eyes get real wide, don't they?
How about the anticipation on the play? Reading, reacting, and then the ability to catch the football and take it in the opposite direction.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The Seahawks offense now, they get ready to come back onto the field. And last time, decent field position through the pick six, obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last one didn't bother you too much last time?
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position and not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play, too.
Now a handoff as they run left side. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Man, it wasn't that long ago that the guy playing that spot was an outside linebacker type of a guy. Now, as a defensive end, how about the speed that he used to get into the backfield and make the play?
And now a timeout coming from the defensive side for the Packers. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. And the offense behind the chains here, a touch on second and 11. Now Wilson, it bites him off, but now he's swallowed up and taken down. Nick Perry, he's the one to get him, and that's sack number 7 for him on the year. Wilson of the Seahawks looking for something big following the sack. It's third and long here. From the shotgun, Wilson. And he locates Luke Wilson. And they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45. Back now at Lambeau. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point. Just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the fourth quarter. Some pretty good games all weekend. We may have saved the best for last. This Monday night game has been a dandy. They go play action here on first down. He's got his man on the crossing route. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A very solid gain of 27. So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. A handoff as they run the counter play. And he'll lose yardage here, going down back at the 28. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. Run blitz there defensively, something we might see more of here in the fourth quarter.
I think we'll see a lot of it, and the difference between that and a pass blitz, you're just trying to get to the quarterback. You're trying to scheme someone open who will get to the QB and make sure he gets on the ground. In a run blitz, you're actually trying to cover up gaps, trying to cover up holes so they can't run the football.
They get 11 back on that one. It leads to third down. This drive, it's been a good mix. Three passing plays, three runs, hitting on all three of those passes, and the last one putting him in the red zone.
So wouldn't you think play action right here? Because you've got the ability and had the ability to run it and throw it. Go play action and take your shot at the end zone.
Pull out, pull out, pull out.
dazzle on third and short. And he's brought down. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive. They come out here in the eye. In motion left, the tight end. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he is going to lose yardage here. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up in the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. Offense looks to punch it in here from the one on second and goal. And that play's not going to get him in as he stopped right at about the line of scrimmage. They hold him again, and now all of a sudden it's third and goal at the one. Well, they held him out on second down, and now here's third and goal. They come out with one back and three tight ends. Third and goal. Can the offense punch it in here from the one? And I don't think he got there. No, they stop him right where it all started. No gain on the play, and what to do now on fourth and goal? So a big kick coming now for Dan Bailey. From the left hash, he'll have to cut this at a tight angle. Now the holder's going to keep it. He's going to try to run for it. And he's across the chalk, into the end zone. Touchdown, Seahawks. It's their quarterback, keeping it himself from a yard out. And the Seahawks add on to their lead. And his guys will take a 10-point lead. They're down here in the fourth, and that personal foul penalty is not going to help.
No, in these types of situations, players will tell you that's extra intensity. From where we sit, it's actually frustration, not a good play.
Bailey now to kick this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Now the Packers get set to go. To begin the drive, and he'll get this one up to the 26. Now we're going to get a halt in the action because Ty Montgomery is shaken up. While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break. Second down following the run. On play action, it's Garoppolo. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete.
Brandon, it looked like he had his hands on it for a moment, but let's face it, that was going to be a tough catch all the way because of the presence of the defense right there as he was trying to haul it in.
Yeah, nice job to force the incompletion. The Packers on third down. They've converted 3 times and 8 chances. This is 3rd and 9. Garoppolo looks to throw. They go screen pass to Hyde. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. The screen gets 7, but it's not enough, and it'll be 4th down.
He dialed up the screen pass on 3rd down, and for a second, it looked like it was all going to come together, and they had a chance to pick up a 1st down, but the defense got there and finished it off.
touchdown. Over the middle, complete. It's Burton. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. The completion good for three, and it's second down.
This possession means so much for them. They've got to focus on this drive and find a way to make this a one-possession game. Yes. Got to get a score.
Yeah, so good with a field goal. Don't necessarily need a touchdown. And now whistles and a flag, and I think we got a jump here. So they got him coming up from his linebacker spot.
And sometimes the position designation really doesn't matter. If you creep up to the line of scrimmage, you just have to look for the football. Make sure it moves before you do.
So this brings up a second and two. Shotgun snap for Garoppolo. His throw incomplete.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. The Packers on third down. They've converted a third of their opportunities, 3 for 9. This time they face a third and two. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's got a first down as he's up to the 48. Just a gain of a couple, but good enough to keep the drive rolling. The job one to pick up the first down is complete. That was a big third down conversion, but they got to watch the clock. It's starting to become their enemy a bit here in a two-score game.
Which means they have to pick up the pace, right? The tempo has to be up. And what they do is they tell the quarterback in his helmet, hey, listen, when we pick up the first down here, tell everyone we're going. We're moving now. The two-minute offensive phase and everyone on the bench area, they're waving them along too. Let's go, let's go, let's go.
And the eighth play on this drive coming up. There's Garoppolo on first and 10. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. And he'll be brought down inside the 20 at the 19. Calling a pickup of 7, and it's a second down. To throw, it's Garoppolo. Touchdown, Packers! Trey Burton with his second TD of the game, his 6th on the year. And the Packers have cut it back within a score.
I'm not sure win-win is the proper term here, but it certainly felt like it. They got the touchdown they needed. But if I'm on the defensive side of the ball, okay, you got the touchdown, but it sure took you a long time.
Yeah, because offensively, though, you're probably hoping for a 1-5 play drive. That one ate up a little more time than they were hoping.
You're exactly right. And if you have that 1-5 play drive, you actually build up momentum and even more hope. When they had to slog their way downfield, they got the touchdown, but it's almost like, yeah, you know.
Doesn't feel right.
Exactly.
The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offensive helmet.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense get the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a 3-and-out. So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your D for that. They've got to take care of their own business and reestablish themselves now that they're back on the field.
And now here's a carry heading left. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. And now just 3 seconds before the two-minute warning, they're going to call a timeout here defensively. And the offense here just looking to stay in bounds, complete the short passes, and put this game on ice.
Here we go.
And now he'll tuck it and run. And that winds up a decent run, and it also takes us to the two-minute warning. Time for a break. We're back to see what happens after this. As big of a play as we've had in this one so far. This is 3rd and 3. Throwing now is Wilson. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete. So now it's fourth down and short, and whatever they do, run or pass it, they've got to pick up the first here.
Yeah, and you mentioned running it. That is still an option, but as you also said, they've got to do it quickly and get back to the line of scrimmage.
And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. And this will hit just beyond the goal line as it's into the end zone for a touchback. The Packer offense now ready to get back onto the field. And things are starting to move in the right direction. They get the touchdown last drive, then their defense gets them the football back.
Yeah, now they have a chance to get the lead if they can put something together here. And I'm eager to see how they decide to do it. Do they want to be methodical, or do they want to take the big strike and go after it right now?
Shipped together here from the D-line. They'll look to throw. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, Sean Lee. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. And so much for the game-winning two-minute drive. I think that interception return there pretty much seals the deal.
And one thing to keep in mind, in this situation with the score that close, defense isn't backing off and just giving you easy throws. They're playing aggressively as well, and they end up picking that one off and sealing the deal for themselves.
And a great spot to start this drive from here. And they give this time to the tailback. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside. And the offense moving in the wrong direction here now as they face a second and 12. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll at least get him inside the red zone here, down to about the 19. 3 yards on the pickup there, and they've got it back to third and 10.
I like it. I like the call. Still an opportunity to run the football and chew up a little more time off the clock.
The Seahawks on third down. They've converted a third of their opportunities, 3 for 9. This is third and 10. And they're going to take it all the way down and just take the delay. He didn't seem in a rush. I guess they just didn't know where the play clock was.
I think you're right about that because there was no hurried movements there, right? No up-tempo at all. Clock just ran out. I think he was as surprised as maybe his bench was.
The Seahawks on third down. They've converted a third of their opportunities, 3 for 9. This will be third and 15. Now a handoff here to his running back. And they'll bring him down at the 18-yard line. That'll be good for 6, but now it's fourth down. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him. So when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, it makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
So the field goal unit is on the field as this is a big spot right here. This one from 35 yards away. And his kick is right there. It's good. And that will double their lead as it's up to 6. So after the pick, they can't capitalize for 6, but they do get 3.
And I know in this situation, most of us want to focus on the offense. You know what side of the ball I played on. Let's give that defense a lot of credit. Taking it over in a sudden change situation and shutting them down.
And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. They have time here, partner, for just one final heave.
And I have to look at from the defense's perspective here. We know what they're going to do on offense. The Hail Mary, try and get guys down there and throw it in the end zone, tip it around and catch it. You've got to have guys back there to defend that, but also you can't allow the quarterback as much time as he wants to set up and throw it. Maybe you bring a little extra pressure to make sure he gets rid of it quicker.
A little bit of a cat and mouse game. We'll see if they bring that pressure. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains. And he did exactly what they needed him to do, Charles. Got out of bounds. They have no timeouts.
And they knew that before the play even began. Still executed it. How many times have we seen it happen where you know it, yet a guy's still looking for a timeout or trying to stay in bounds? He got it done.
One final try now for Garoppolo. Flushed out right. And it's incomplete. So their final drive comes up empty. And with that, the ball game is over. Well, going into the final play of this game, they knew that they needed some type of a miracle there at the very end, but they couldn't get it done. However, we were treated to really a spectacular affair.
Even though they didn't finish it off, you're exactly right. They took us down to the last play where still you're wondering, could it happen? Possibly, even though we both knew it was a long shot.
So for the Seahawks, they'll finish the first half of the schedule dead even at 4-4. And they'll have another road date next week with the New York Giants. Meanwhile, for Green Bay, their season is on life support somewhat now at 3-6. And they're going to get an extra week to stew over this as they're not back in action until week 11. So that'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. From Lambeau, good night, everybody.